Hi guys, welcome again to our Micro C Pro for Peak Tutorials for Absolute Beginners series. This is tutorial 41, part 2 of our digital clock with the DS1307 real-time clock. In part 1, we designed the circuit diagram, the LCD we connected to port B. We've got 3 push buttons connected to RA0. This is going to be used to enter into the configuration mode. We've got the up and down push buttons connected to RA1 and RA2, and our DS1307 connected to this R2C serial bus. In this tutorial, we're going to continue with the code that we wrote for the interfacing DS1307 tutorial. In that tutorial, we learned how we can read data from the DS1307 and display it to our LCD. In this tutorial, we're going to continue with that. We're going to see how we can also write configuration data to our DS1307. So this is the code that we wrote in that previous tutorial, the LCD connections. And this is the function that we created to read data from our DS1307. As you can still remember, these are the few steps that you need to read data from the DS. The first thing is to send the start command. Then you'll have to send the device address followed by the direction bit, 0 for write, 1 for read. Then we're going to send the address of the register that you want to access. After that, we're going to repeat start followed by the command to read data from that register. And then we're going to say read data, which is our local variable. It's going to be equals to I2Read, which is going to read the content of that register. And after that, we're going to stop. And we created 2 functions, the MSB. This is to display the most significant bit of our BCD number because data is stored in BCD format in our DS1307 date and data registers. And this is the function to display the least significant bit. We're going to have these 2 functions, whether we're going to read or we're going to write. These are the global variables that we're going to use, the second, the minute, the hour. And the first thing we said, OSCON is 66. This is to configure to the 8 MHz internal oscillator. Then the first I2C function is I2C1 init. Then we're going to configure our DS to run at 100K. Then we're going to initialize our LCD. Then we're going to display time and date. And in the while one loop, second equals to read DS1307, which is our function to read data from the DS. We're going to substitute the address with 0 to read the second. We're going to substitute it with 1 to read the minute and so on. And after that, we're going to store it into our time and date arrays and then display to our LCD display. This simulation is reading data from my local PC. The time is displayed on the first row and the date display on the second row. Even if we press the buttons, nothing will happen because we haven't configured them. So the first thing that we're going to start with, we're going to configure our port A, the RA0, RA1 and RA2. Connect our push buttons on those pins. The first thing, we're going to configure these analog pins as digital input-output pins so that we can be able to read data from those pins. Then the tri-state register, this is configure these 3 pins as input pins. Just initialize with 0. Once we switch on our project, we're going to display on the first line, student companion. And on the second line, digital clock. And then after 3-second delay, we're going to clear the screen and start displaying the content of our DS1307 real-time clock. This is our function to read the content of our DS1307. We're going to write also another function to write configuration data to our DS1307. If you want to set the time or date by the user, we can use this function. We're going to name it write DS1307. It's going to have 2 arguments. The first one is unsigned short address. This is going to be the address of the register that we're going to access. And unsigned short write data, this is going to be the content, the data that we're going to write to that register. As with the read steps, to write to the DS1307 is similar. The first thing is to send a start command. Then the second step is a device address followed by the direction bit, 0 for write and 1 for read. this case is going to be D0. Then we're going to send the address of the register that you want to access. Then we're going to write to that register. And after that, we're going to send a stop command. Because the content of our registers are in BCD format, we cannot add or subtract this BCD information. We have to convert it to binaries so that we can be able to manipulate this data. So we're going to create two more functions. One is to convert the BCD to binary when we are reading, and the other one is to convert the binary to BCD when we are writing to our device. This is the function that we created, int binary to BCD. This is going to be used to convert the binary content to BCD. And this function is going to be to convert the BCD information to binary so that we can be able to manipulate our information. The other two variables that we're going to declare is unsigned short set count. This is going to count the number of positions when we are setting our date and time. Whenever we press the set button for the first time, it's going to shift to the hour position. When we press it for the second time, it's going to shift to the minute position so that we can set the minute and so on. This variable is going to keep track of the number of times we have pressed the set button. And short set, this is a variable that we're going to use to save the status of the set button if you've pressed it or not. So let us write the code to write the configuration data into our device. The first thing we're going to check if the set button is pressed. If this button is pressed, then we're going to go into our configuration mode. If port A.fo equals to 0, then after a short delay, this is just to debound the switch. We're going to check again if this button has been pressed. Then we're going to increment set count by 1. And if set count is greater than 7, then we're going to reset the set count. This is basically because we've got 6 positions. The first one is to set the hour. The second one is to set the minute. The third one is to set the second. The fourth one is to set the day. The fifth one is to set the month. And the sixth one is to set the year. Once we reach over 7, then we're going to reset our set count. If the set button has been pressed, then we're going to check whether it was the up button. We're going to set the set variable equals to 1. But if it was the down button, then we're going to decrement set with 1. Then we're going to select the switch set count. The first case, we're going to select case 1 to set the hour. We're going to convert the value of hour, which is in BCD format. We're going to convert it to binary so that we can do the calculation. Hour equals to hour plus 1 if we have pressed the up button. And if it's the minus button set here, it's going to have a value of minus, which is going to decrease the value of hour. And after that, we're going to convert this binary to BCD format so that we can save it into our device. The function to use is write DS1307, and the address of the hour is 2, and the content is going to be hour. The second case is for the minute. We're going to do the same. Convert the BCD to binary, change the minute. If the minute is greater equals to 60, we reset it to 0. If it's less than 0, we reset it to 59. Then we convert the minute to BCD format so that we can save it into our device using the same function. The register address is 1 and the content is minute. Then we break from the loop. For the second, we're not going to modify the second. We're just going to reset it to 0. The day, we're going to do the same thing. The month, we're going to do the same thing. And the year, we're going to do the same thing. If you can read from the datasheet, it says the DS1307 can be run in either 12-hour or 24-hour mode. Bit 6 of the hour register is defined as a 12-hour or 24-hour mode select bit. When high, the 12-hour mode is selected. In the 12-hour mode, bit 5 is the AM-PM bit, with logic high being the PM. In 24-hour mode, bit 5 the second 10-hour bit, 20 to 23 hours. It says again, the hours value must be re-entered whenever the 12 to 24 hour mode bit is selected. So this is how you can change your configuration if you want to display your hour in 12 hour or 24 hour mode. So this is how you can select the AP information from your hour value. If the AP is 1, Then we're going to select PM, and if it's zero, we're going to select AM. Let us build our project. Finish successfully. Let us run our simulation. Say student companion, digital clock on the second line, and after 3 seconds, it's going to display the time and date information. The current information, because the simulation is reading from our PC. If I press the set button, now I can change the hour value. If I press the up, you can see it goes up 5, then 6. If I press the down, it goes to 5, then 4. If I press the set button again, you can see the minute changes, 6, 8. If I press the down, they go down. If I press the set button again, it's going to go to the second. If I press up, you can see it resetting the second, because we said there is no point of setting the second. We just reset it to zero, whether you press the up or the down. And if I press the set button again, now I can change the date information. If I press, it goes up, down, it goes down. If I press the set button again, now I can change the month information. If I press up, it's going up. If I press down, can modify the month. And lastly, if I press the set button again, I can change the year information. Can go up, go down, and so on. If I press set again, then I'm gonna skip the configuration mode. Even if I press the button, you can see nothing is changing. So this is basically how you can design a digital clock. Thank you guys for watching this tutorial. Don't forget to subscribe to this YouTube channel to receive more tutorials in the future. And I'll see you guys in the next tutorial. Thank you.